Hello and welcome to this Swift and Xcode tutorial. My name's Cal and today we're going to be building a timer application that when you close it off completely and reopen it, the timer continues to count. I made a video very similar to this a couple of months back and a lot of you have been asking me for how to put this on a background thread or how do I make it so when the app is closed completely and we reopen it that the time is remembered and it continues counting. We're going to use UserDefaults to achieve this, so we're going to take the date and save that and then compare the current time with the date that the timer was started. So stick around and let's get started. New Swift and Xcode project, iOS app that we're building. I'm going to call this background timer and just hit finish and create. Let's head into our main storyboard and it's just going to be a very basic timer sort of design. So we're just going to have our time label, which is just going to be a text. I'm just changing that to all zeros. We're going to say center horizontally in the safe area and giving it a little bit of space to the top. We're going to make the font size a little bit bigger, so 55, and just update the view there. And then we're going to set align top to 30. We're going to drag in a button, change the font size to 40. Just going to rename this one to start and then hit copy and paste and renaming this one to a reset button. And then we're going to give our start button some space to our time label and then to the left of our safe area and then to the right of our reset button and the reset button to the right of our safe area. And then we're going to say center vertically off our start button. And we're just going to head in and modify all of those horizontal constraints to be zero. And then we just need one more constraint, which is equal widths for our buttons. Cool, so let's open up the assistant editor and create some outlets. I'm just going to create an outlet for our time label. So just right click and drag above our viewDidLoad, just calling that time label. And another one for our start stop button. I'm going to create a outlet for our reset button. And then we're going to right click and drag below our viewDidLoad and create a start stop action. And the same thing for our reset button, so a reset action. Cool, so let's close off the assistant editor and head into our main view controller. Just going to tidy up the file a little bit and then we're going to create a variable calling it timer counting, which is a boolean, and that's going to be initialized to false. And then we're going to create another variable calling it start time, which is an optional date, and then another variable calling it stop time, again an optional date. And then we're going to say let UserDefaults equal to capital UserDefaults and just standard. Now we're going to create a few static strings. The first ones are going to be our start time key, which is we're just going to call start time. And then we're going to duplicate that line two more times. So we're going to have a stop time key as well as a counting key. So these strings can just be whatever you want. Declaring them in all caps like that, you know that they're a final string. Then we're going to create a function calling it set start time. So this is going to be updating our user defaults. So it's going to receive a date and we're just going to set our start time equal to the date that's passed in, as well as setting the user defaults values. So we're going to say user defaults set our date for our start time key. And then we're also going to create another function calling it set stop time, which is just going to do the exact same thing but for our stop time. And then we're going to do one more for our timer counting, except this is going to receive a boolean instead of a date. And we're just going to set our timer counting equal to the value that's passed through. And I actually forget to put in the for key, it needs to be our counting key. We'll come back to that later. And I'm just changing the variables passed through. It doesn't actually matter. It just seems a little bit more correct. Yeah, we could have just left that. Now inside our viewDidLoad, we're going to load whatever is saved in the user defaults and try and pull it out. So we're just going to say our start time is equal to user defaults object for key, and then giving it our start time key as an optional date. And the same thing for our stop time. So for our stop time key as an optional date and our timer counting, we're going to say user defaults boolean for our key counting key. And so that's not optional. Now inside our start stop action, we're going to say if our timer is counting, we want to set our stop time with the exact current time. So to do that, you just want to call date and then a bracket giving it no initializers. So that's just the current time. Create a function calling it stop timer. And then otherwise we want to start the timer and we're just going to create a function for that as well. So just copying our stop timer and renaming that to start timer. We're going to head right up to the top and declare a scheduled timer, which is of type timer. And now in our start timer, we can say scheduled timer is equal to timer, scheduled timer. And we want the one with time interval, target selector, user info and repeats. So our time interval is 0.1, target is self, user info, we're going to pass through nil, repeats is true. And the selector, we just need to give it an Objective-C function. So I'm just going to say hash selector, and then we're going to create the function calling it refresh value. So that's just going to call our refresh value function every 0.1 second. So 10 times every second. And just below that, we're going to set timer counting equal to true. Our start stop button title, we're going to set it to stop for our state normal. And we're going to set the title color to UI color red for state normal as well. And we can do the exact same thing, except the opposite for our stop timer. So instead of creating a new timer, we're just going to say scheduled timer invalidate. And we just want to put this inside if our scheduled timer is not nil. We're going to set timer counting equal to false, the title to start, and the color to our system green.
Now inside our refresh value, we're going to say if let start equal to start time, actually saying if there's a value in our start time, we're going to calculate the difference. If the current date time, so the exact millisecond time interval since our start time, we're going to set our time label with the int value of the difference. And we need to create a function for this. So we're just going to say function set time label, which is going to receive an integer, which is in milliseconds. And we want to display this on our time label. So we're going to create another function calling it seconds to hours, minutes, seconds. And it's going to receive an int, which is milliseconds, and return three ints. So the first one's going to be an hour, which is equal to our milliseconds divided by 3,600. Our minute is going to be equal to our milliseconds percentage 3,600 divided by 60. And our seconds is going to be the same thing, except instead of dividing by 60, we're going to percentage by 60. And then we're just going to return those three in, so hour, minute, and second. And now we're going to create another function, which is going to take our hour, minute, and second and turn that into a string. So we're going to say variable time string, and we're just going to return our time string. We're going to say time string plus equal to the string format, giving it to two decimal places and our hour. And then we're going to say plus equal to the little space between our time. And then we're going to paste that down two more times and then remove the bottom line and then just changing it to minutes and seconds. And now in our set time label, we can say let time equal to seconds, hours, minutes, and giving it our value, so our millisecond value. And then say time string is equal to make time string, giving it our time zero, time one, and time two, so hours, minutes, seconds. And then we can say our time label text is equal to our time string. Before we start our timer from our start stop action, we just want to check to see if the user has stopped the timer. So we're going to say if let stop equal to stop time. So if there's a value in our stop time, meaning that the user has stopped the timer at some point, we're going to say let restart time equal to a function, which we're going to calculate the restart time. So our restart time function is going to receive a start date as well as a stop date and return a date. So we're going to say let difference equal to the start and then time interval from our start to our stop. So the difference between the two dates. And next we want to return a new date, but we want to add whatever the timer was up to, so say 15 seconds, we want to add that to our new date. So we're going to say adding time interval and giving it our difference. Cool, so we now need to just pass through those dates through our calculate restart time, so just giving it a start time, and we're also going to pass it through our stop time, and then we're just going to set our user default stop time equal to nil and our start time equal to restart time. Otherwise, if there is no stop time, we just want to set our user default start time to our start time. Cool, so let's head down and fill out our reset time action. So if the time is reset, we just want to set our stop time equal to nil, as well as we want to set our start time equal to nil. We're going to set our time label text equal to make time string. We're just going to pass it through all zeros. And then finally, just calling our stop timer function. And then we're going to head right back up to the top, because if the timer is counting and the user closes the app and then reopens it, we need to set the time label back to the correct time. So we're just going to say if our timer is counting, we're going to start our timer. Otherwise, we're going to stop our timer, calling both of those functions. If let start is equal to our start time, and then we're also going to say if let stop is equal to our stop time, ensuring that both of those dates are not nil. Our time is equal to our calculate restart time, and then we're going to say the difference again, so getting the difference between the current time and the time interval since our restart time. And then we're going to set our time label with the int value of the difference of those times. And finally, we're just going to tie up a few loose ends. In our refresh value, we just want to say if there isn't a start time, we're going to stop our timer and set our time label back to zero, so back to empty. If in our start stop action, our stop time is equal to nil, we actually want to set our start time equal to a new date, not the original start time. And then we just want to fix up our for key. We're just going to give that counting key. Cool, so let's build and run this now. And you can see that you can start the timer and it begins to count. And then let's close off the app and wait a few seconds and then reopen it. And you can see that's still counting. It's remembered the time. Let's stop the timer now and close off the app again and see if it remembers our 12 seconds. So that's looking good. And we can start that again. So there you have it. There's how to put a timer on a background thread, essentially. If you found any value in this Swift and Xcode tutorial, give the video a like. Otherwise, I'll catch you guys in the next tutorial. Cheers.